Hello everyone, my name is Shreyas. Welcome back in the next video of programming using Java assignment series. Today we will solve abstract assignment 1. Here problem statement is, an e-commerce company wants to start a payment service application for allowing payments using debit card and credit card. You need to help them in creating the application by implementing the classes based on the class diagram and description given below. Here we can see three class diagrams: payment, debit card payment, and credit card payment. Debit card payment and credit card payment, these both classes extending payment class. In method description, we can see constructor description of these classes and description of payBill method for these both classes. Means this method is overridden. In the description, they have not given payBill method description for payment class, but we can see it in payment class diagram. Means this method will be abstract in the payment class. So we will declare it abstract. In this problem, we will use inheritance and learn concept of abstraction. If you want to clear all doubts, then watch this video till end. Here we will give input in class objects and method parameter. Let's solve this in Eclipse IDE. In payment class, declare three variables: private int customer ID, protected string payment ID, protected double service tax percentage. Then generate parameterized constructor. In this, initialize customer ID. Then generate getter and setters. Then declare abstract payBill method. In this class, we have declared two variables protected because it is a superclass, and if we declared it protected, then these variables can be accessed by these subclasses like debit card payment and credit card payment. Now in debit card payment class, which is extending payment class, declare two variables: private static int counter equal to 1000 and private double discount percentage. Then generate parameterized constructor. In this, we are calling superclass constructor, incrementing counter, and set payment ID as they have given in the method description. Then generate getter and setter methods. Now create a body for payBill method. Then this is a condition to set service tax percentage. Then set service tax amount. Then this is a condition to set discount percentage. Then calculate discount amount. And finally, this method will return bill amount. Similarly, in credit card payment class, create only private static int variable counter. Then generate constructor. In this, we are calling superclass constructor, incrementing counter, and set payment ID. Then generate getter and setter method for counter. Then in payment method, we will set service tax percentage using if else condition. This method will return bill amount. And this class is complete. Now to understand working of this code, we will see tester class. In tester class, we can see on line number 4 and 11, class objects are created. And below that objects, payBill method is called and rounded off output, put in a bill amount variable. Below that, this is a code for printing other information using getter and setters. I think now you have understood the working of this code. And if you have any doubt, then you can ask in comment section. Here we got write output. So let's copy this code and paste in the site to run test cases. Here all test cases are passed. So it's all for today. Thanks for watching.